Hi everyone, and welcome to Omnitronics Unboxing. I'm Craig Hannaford, and today we have something very exciting to unbox, the IPR400 Series 2. This device is a versatile, multi-channel, two-in-one interoperability and RoIP gateway that promises to revolutionise how we connect and manage radio communications. The Series 2 was released back in July 2022 and is an evolution of the popular IPR400 product. Before we get to the unboxing, let me give you a quick overview of the IPR400 Series 2. This device is designed to combine voice over IP extensions for analog radio equipment and provide interoperability between different radio systems. It features four ports that can be linked internally or with VoIP in various configurations, making it ideal for connecting repeater sites. It also supports SIP connectivity for dispatch consoles like ReadyTalk Flex and OmniCore, making it highly flexible for various communication setups. Now let's see what's inside the box. We have the QR code that lets you send an email to the Omnitronics support and maintenance team if you have any troubles setting up the gateway. How quickly your response is to this request will depend on the type of support plan you purchase with your product. So let's proceed and get it open. As we open the lid, the first thing we see here when we look up is another QR code to contact the OmniCare support and maintenance team. As we look down, you can see there on the left of the top of the device, there is a leaflet with a URL address that you can navigate to download the manual using the supplied coupon access code. This is extremely helpful to set up your device in the specified configuration you intend to use this device for. On the right of the device, we can see the factory acceptance test sheet. This shows you the default settings from the factory and the baseline setting on your purchase device. As you can see, to the left and to the right of the product, there are several cables supplied for the product installation. This includes some mounting hardware and patch cables for the initial connections. There's everything you need to get started with this product. Underneath the paperwork, we have the IPR400 Series 2 itself, securely nested in its packaging. Let's take it out and have a closer look. The device itself has a robust build, comes in a convenient 19-inch 1AU rack mount assembly for ease of installation into a customer's existing communications rack. It has clearly labelled ports front and rear. On the front panel, from the left to right, we have the Ethernet connector for interfacing to the network, three status LED indicators, a USB port for debugging and local configuration, and finally, the menu rotation push button for navigating the display, menu button, and backlit multifunctional LCD display. To the rear of the device, we have, from left to right, the power and earth lug connections, the four DB9 serial port and data connections, the four RJ45 4-wire E&M ports, and the D25 auxiliary connector. Now that everything is out of the box, let's focus more on the IPR400 Series 2 functionality. We will start by having a look at the front and rear connections. On the back, you will find the four main radio ports, additional input-output port, and network connections for SNMP monitoring and web configuration. The flexibility this product offers is impressive. You can link groups of radios, use SIP for voice connections, and even configure everything through a web browser via OmniLink. The software configurable E&M signals make it super easy to set up, whether you need contact, voltage, or switched operation. Plus, with real-time remote control via OmniLink and PTT over cellular using ESChat, Tate, Team PTT, and Tate Axiom, to name a few. So where are the devices used and what are their application? These devices are very versatile and can be used to connect several channels together. Two radio repeater sites can be linked together using IP connections. When dealing with multiple sites using analog two-way radio that are far apart, connecting repeater sites using IP is an effortless way to join communications between them. This feature has been used in the St John's Ambulance WA dispatch system to connect multiple talk paths together statewide with full redundancy to the state of Western Australia. Another application is where the high path loss environment exists. In two-way radio communication environments, where UHF and VHF signals cannot pass through walls or obstacles, line of sight communications is often deemed necessary to overcome radio signal path loss, but line of sight may not actually be required. This has been done in a mining environment to link surface radios to the leaky feeder system underground. Terrestrial systems that connect to tunnels or underground environments. Another application is connecting analog equipment to P25 talk paths. Connecting analog equipment like phones, consoles or radios to P25 talk groups has never been easier with this range of Omnitronics, RoIP and interoperability gateways. Emergency services, public safety agencies and government organisations are increasingly moving to state or countrywide P25 systems, offering improved voice clarity, encryption capabilities and interoperabilities between different agencies. This solution has been implemented in the village of Melrose Park, who recently won the APCO International Technology Leadership Award for this remarkable solution. So that's everything inside the box of the IPR400 Series 2 from Omnitronics. My initial impressions are they're very positive, and it's packed with features that promises to enhance radio communication setups significantly. Thanks for watching. If you've enjoyed this unboxing, please give it the thumbs up and subscribe on the Omnitronics channel and stay tuned for more product demos.